So the other day, I was having coffee with my friend. She's in her 30s. She's been in the same career field for a while, and she looked at me and said, "Hey, I feel stuck in my career, and I'm thinking about a career change into data. Where do I start?" And she's really not the first person who has asked me this. I've had several friends reach out, and a lot of you guys, ever since I started my YouTube channel, asked me the very same question. So in this video, I'm going to give you my five eye-opening tips on how to become a data analyst, as well as how you can use these to your advantage. Now let's get started. I'll be honest, the easiest way to get into the data analyst field will be by using data in your current role. That's how I was able to pivot my career into the data analyst role, as well as so many other people that I know. As a consultant, my job wasn't to do data analysis, but I had access to claims data, so as much as I could, I would start building reports with this data and start trying out my own different analysis to start gaining some data experience. So if you're currently working, start digging around and getting your hands on data. Start thinking about the problems that you can solve for your company using data analysis, and you can really start gaining some data experience regardless of what your job title is. And if you don't know where to start, I'd recommend you partner with your manager. Your manager is there to help grow your career, and I really didn't know that I should be spending my one-on-one time with my manager focusing on career goals rather than projects. And these are the times you want to let them know that you want to start growing your data career, and a good manager will start giving you resources and data projects for you to get started. And if your company has an IT team or technical data people, start talking to them, make friends, figure out what skills they're using, what types of projects they're working on, and that's how you can slowly start getting some mentorship and learning from others within your organization. My next tip is to create a learning plan. Everyone's plan is going to look really different depending on where they currently are and what roles they want to apply for. My first recommendation is to get familiar with all the data roles out there. There's data scientist, data analyst, data engineer, many more data roles, and you don't have to be a data analyst first to enter into all these other data roles. But what you want to do here is understand what types of roles are out there and which of these roles interests you. Once you have an idea of the type of data role you're looking for, now you want to look at the job descriptions of the ones that you actually want to apply for. Understand what the day-to-day skills are for these jobs, as well as what are the interview requirements that you're going to have to pass in order to get these jobs. And next, do a self-assessment. Assess what are the skills that I currently already have and what are the skills that I need to learn in order to get to the job descriptions that I want to apply for? And a tip here is to not overlook the soft skills. Most people spend all their time focused on just learning the technical skills, but the soft skills will be very important for you to break into the data industry. You want to have skills like being able to ask the right questions, being able to present, and being able to communicate your findings. Just make sure that you're listing all the skills that you will need to attain, not just the technical ones. Once you start learning skills, you'll want to then start practicing and showing off your skills. Learning skills is one thing, but demonstrating that you know how to use them to solve real problems is another. And that's the biggest gap that I see in people trying to break into the industry. They know how to use Excel, SQL, and Tableau, but they don't know how to use them together, and being able to demonstrate that is a challenge. So there are two great ways you can start applying your data analysis skills. The first is to test yourself. I've learned that one of the best ways for me to learn anything technical is by testing myself, and that's why I'm so excited to talk about today's sponsor, who is DataCamp. You guys know I've used DataCamp to practice and learn hands-on SQL, and they actually have certifications where you can test yourself. The data analyst certification is focused on testing the exact skills that a data analyst should know. This includes exploratory data analysis, SQL, and advanced skills like R and Python. The certification has two tests, and one of them is a practical exam where you'll have a business problem to solve and present using your data analysis skills. And if you do not have any data analysis skills, do not worry. They have a curated list of courses that you can take to prepare for these exams. And you can start practicing and showing off your data analyst skills by clicking the link in the description below. That'll take you to this page where you can get started. And another great way to practice your data analyst skills is through projects. Projects is a great way for anybody who doesn't have the ability to get hands-on data work on the job. And what is a project? Well, to simply explain it, it's just a problem that you're solving with data. You're going to have a data set, you're going to define your objective, and then you're going to use all your data analysis skills that you learned to be able to solve the problem and present your findings. This reinforces your data analyst skills as well as shows off your data analysis work. As projects is a whole separate topic, I will link the video above that goes into how you can get started with projects. Once you have a project complete, you'll want to start marketing yourself. Use your projects to update your LinkedIn and your resume. And I will be honest, it's gonna take some time to create a really good LinkedIn and resume profile that will stand out to recruiters. You can do this by showing the impact of your work and quantifying it, as well as including any data work that you've done to really show off your skills. My recommendation is to not wait until you feel like you have enough projects to start updating your resume and LinkedIn. I say do it as you finish a project or as you learn a skill. Add SQL to your profile because it's never too early to start, and you want to start putting yourself out there. And a big tip here is to start networking and using job referrals. A job referral is not a guarantee that you'll get an interview, but it is a great way to make yourself stand out and increase your chances of getting that interview. From my personal experience, I found that having a personal reference does make a huge difference. So if you can start, go out there and start making your connections on LinkedIn. And my next step is have the right attitude. The process of becoming a data analyst is not easy. Along the way, you are going to get discouraged, question yourself, think about whether this is the right career for you. When I was trying to transition my career and learn new skills, I found it extremely challenging and overwhelming. But hindsight, I'm really glad I decided to stick with it even when I wanted to quit. It really took a lot of late hours of studying on top of my full-time job, putting out a lot of applications, failing a lot of interviews. And so for anyone in a similar position where they're trying to pivot their career, land a new data role, then I would say be patient with yourself, have the right attitude, don't doubt yourself, and just continue working towards your goals. I would love to know which of these tips was most helpful to you in the comments. And if you did enjoy this video, please like and subscribe as I have more data tips coming. And thank you so much. I will see you on the next one.